Hi, I'm Dala, and today we're going to be upgrading the battery on this 2011 Nissan Leaf with a newer one, a 30kWh pack from a 2017 model. Let's get started! So the first step is to jack up the car. I always use some ramps along with jack stands to make it stand up quite a bit from the floor in order to be able to extract the battery from the side. So, first step is to remove the 12-volt battery. So, close all doors and wait 2 minutes before disconnecting the 12-volt lead-acid battery. Once the 12-volt battery has been removed, you can then move on to the high-voltage service disconnect plug under the back seat. Okay. The service disconnect plug is located here in the back seat, behind this cover that is fastened with 3 10mm bolts. As always, when you're dealing with these orange high voltage things, you should wear the appropriate PPE. So here this is class 0 high voltage gloves. So in order to remove the fuse, you simply pop up this small tab and lift up the green one and pull out. Nice. Next order of business is to crawl under the car and remove all the splash shields. So these ones are held on with 10mm bolts and these plastic clips that you simply pop out. And there is a total of 3 of these plastic underbellies that you will need to remove. When you're working under a dirty car, it's a good idea to wear some protective glasses because dirt will get in your eyes. So there are 2 cables that you need to disconnect under the battery. I'm just going to be showing you on this pack instead because it's a bit easier to film. So the first one is the communication plug. This is the same one on both generations. So to unclip it, simply turn it counterclockwise and it will move outwards. And then you can simply pop it out. So this cable, the high voltage cable, is the next one that you're going to be removing. When you're doing this under the car, you need to have your class 0 gloves on. I'm gonna show you a bit. It's normally fastened like this to the battery, but on the underside, you will see a few things here. The first one is this blue tab. This is the first thing that you will pull down. Secondly, there are 2 tabs that need to be depressed. One is here on the side, and the other one is here. So as you drag this downwards or towards you, you will have to depress both at the same time in order to get this to move fully back. Once you are done, it should look something like this, and then you can start to focus on getting the actual battery pack out. Under the vehicle, there are 8 17mm bolts that you will need to crack open. I recommend doing it with a breaker bar before applying some sort of impact or anything else. All around the battery, there are 8 17mm bolts spanning the outside perimeter of the battery. But also on the rear, there are 2 places where the battery also attaches to the frame. So look out for these 2. A total of 10 bolts. So on the rear of the battery, on the left side, we have the older style bolt, which the older Leaf uses. But the newer style battery uses a much more thinner thread bolt. So when you're installing the new battery, you will have to get yourself a pair of these types of bolts. One thing I forgot to mention that you should also remove before removing the battery are these ground straps that connect on the front of the battery. There are 2 of them. This one is actually starting to look a bit corroded, and there is actually a recall campaign ongoing. So you can bring your Leaf in and get a new set of these installed for free. So I definitely recommend checking that out if you haven't done so already for your car. Once all the bolts have been removed, the battery can be lifted down and dragged out from the side. The 24kWh battery weighs a total of 273kg. So you will need to use some appropriate gear for safely lowering it down. So here we are underneath the car. And this is the rear where the battery attached. And the newer battery works a bit differently. The bolt holes are not on the exactly the same place. So you have to drill out these rear supports. I have put some markers here so that I know how much to drill out. So let's get to drilling. So here are the brackets after being drilled out and some protective coating applied to them so they won't rust. So here we have the two communication plugs for the battery. On the left side we have the older standard, the 22 pin, and on the right the new 36 pin. I sell an adapter cable so that you can get a really easy plug and play upgrade. But today we are going for a budget version, since luckily the new battery came with this short cut plug that I'm gonna be soldering on to the vehicle instead. This can be done, or this is done to save a bit of money, because these connectors are usually quite pricey, so that is why I am opting for the solder move here. Okay, so here I am now mid-splice. The old connector, the 22 pin, has been cut off and the 36 pin has been spliced on. This is not something that I recommend, but this is a budget build today. So yeah, I would much rather recommend using the ready-made harness adapter instead, so you don't have to do any splicing, because that introduces an additional failure point. Again, this is not needed on the newer model. Like if you're starting to upgrade a Leaf that is 2013 plus, then you will not need to do this modification. But yeah, let's continue. So to make a really nice block off plate for the unused high voltage heater connection, I'm gonna be using this plug that came with the battery, just because it's already designed to fit that space. But there are some modifications needed to this plug before I can mount it. As you can see here, these two high voltage connectors, you can't just plug this in, because then you will have them exposed to the elements. So I'm gonna be opening up this one and pulling out the wires, and instead filling it up with some RTV silicone sealant and then just letting it cure. So first step here is gonna be removing the white hat covering it. So there are a total of 4 clips on each corner that we simply unplug like so, and then it can be removed. Then as you can see, there is some red rubber sealant here that you can simply pry up
like this. Stop.
And now we can remove these wires, and this is done from the other side. You will need a really small screwdriver for this. There are some tabs here on the inside that you need to push up in order to release the pins. So I'm gonna switch to a smaller screwdriver and do just that. So yeah, I'm simply gonna go in here and press these tabs down, and at the same time I'll start pulling on the wire from the other side like so. Pull the pin right out and then do the next one. There are also alternatives to this. You can buy some ready-made plugs that are made for these delete kits, but like I said earlier, this is a budget build, so we are saving some money. So the next step is to then fill this whole assembly with some RTV silicone and then put the cap back on. So let's do that. Now the new battery is mounted, and this is what the connectors look like. On the left we have the unused port filled with the delete cap, in the middle the normal high voltage plug, and on the far right we have the new spliced B24 connector that is 36 pin. Nice! When you're reinstalling the splash guards, some of the bolt holes will not line up, so it is a good idea to take a step drill and make some new holes where appropriate. Luckily all the plastic clips will work, it's just some of the bolt holes that won't line up. But it's much better to do this DIY method instead of buying new splash guards, since this will cost several hundred euros from Nissan. So here is an example of the misaligned bolt hole. So it was simply to drill a new one. So the next step is to install a cannon bridge with the battery upgrade firmware. This vehicle already has a cannon bridge, since it has been running the Leaf Enhancer software to get some additional features. So in this video I'm simply gonna update the firmware to contain the battery upgrade stuff. But I'm still going to show you where the cannon bridge is located on these older models. It is here under the cup holder, so I'm just gonna pop that one off right now. To remove this piece, you don't need any tools. You can just use your hands and pull it upwards. There are also some wires in here that you will need to disconnect. And then one wire still on the other side. Or actually two wires. Here you can see where I have already mounted the cannon bridge. It is held in place with a zip tie around this bar. And yes, you can also see the wiring harness coming off of it. I'm gonna show you where the wiring harness attaches on the other side also, so you can a bit more understand how involving it is to mount this cannon bridge. So let's take a look on this side where the cannon wiring attaches. To remove this piece, you simply need a screwdriver. And there is a plastic clip here that you simply unscrew and then you can pull it out. Like so, simple clip, and then this piece can be just removed. Like so. Here's the cable that goes in from underneath the vehicle and then enters the compartment. And this cable here, I have cut open and I have extracted the green and blue wire, and these ones are then cut here in the middle, and then one set of wires, this bottom one, goes into can one, the battery labeled wiring, and the other one, these two, go into can two, the vehicle side. I have also grounded the cannon bridge here on this bolt, so this is where you do all the work to get the cannon bridge mounted. It's also a good idea to cut out a bit of this carpet. That way you will gain a bit more space to splice the cabling in. Finally then, the power for the cannon bridge. As you can see here, this red wire goes up and it travels along here and it goes to the back of the OBD2 port. There's a yellow wire there that is constant 12 volt. And this wire is then used to supply power to the cannon bridge. I've also mounted a tiny fuse behind here, because the fuse that covers the whole OBD2 port is a bit oversized, so it's always a good idea to install a second fuse just for the cannon bridge. And that wraps up the cannon bridge wiring. That's basically all there is to mount a cannon bridge onto the older ZE0 model. So yeah, short recap. Most of the splice happens here, then you just ground and pull power. And bam, bridge is installed. Okay, so moment of truth. 12 volt battery has been reconnected and also the service disconnect plug. So now it's time for the first startup. Nice. So the installed battery is reading 12 out of 12 bars and no fault codes are active. Very nice. Now it's time for the first charge. And voila! The update is done. And it's now snowing. That's Finland for you. Okay, so while the car is charging, I thought I would mention a few things about this swap. So the car originally came with a 24kWh pack that had like 14 point something kilowatt hours remaining. It only showed, I think it was 9 bars out of 12. So this replacement pack is still very healthy. It is showing full 12 bars. And now the vehicle is like 70%-ish charged, and it's already showing a lot higher range numbers compared to before. I think it was showing something like 100 km max. But now with this 30kWh pack, I think it will probably settle at around maybe 170 or 180 now in winter. But yeah. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this budget upgrade video. A huge shout out to all my Patreon supporters. This channel wouldn't exist without you. And also, if you're planning to do an upgrade on your own, please contact me if you need a can bridge or the adapter cable. Bye!